Today we're going to learn what meta objects actually are, how are they different from meta fields, and some actual examples. And stick around to the end because I'm going to show you an actual tutorial on how to use them. To begin, let's understand what meta objects and meta fields are. In simple terms, both of these features allow you to add additional data or attributes to various sections of your Shopify store. So this extra information can be used to actually enhance the customization and the functionality of your store. However, there are some key differences between the two. With meta fields, we've actually done a bunch of videos using meta fields, and they're more sort of hands-on tutorial type videos, but I never really addressed what meta fields are. So meta fields, you can easily create and display custom content for your online store. So you can think of like ingredients or maybe key features or even related items, care instructions, and more. So meta fields help you manage unique content for each product or collection without needing to change your online store design. So we've done a lot of videos on size charts, adding size charts with meta fields for individual products. Now with meta objects, it's a brand new feature within the custom data, and you can create and manage custom content with your store and deploy it on your website. Meta objects can be used to expand Shopify with richer multi-field content like product highlights, lookbooks, size guides. You can create entirely new commerce objects like raw materials, designer profile, store events, etc. Using meta objects, you can actually create and edit your content in one central place without having to worry about publishing changes to your store's website design or layout. So I want you to think of meta fields as sort of like singular, and I want you to think of meta objects as a group of meta fields, right? So I think a good example would be this clothing store that we have a shirt, we have pants, we have shoes, we have a bunch of different products, you know, throughout the store. We can actually have meta fields and use care instructions, right? We want to just have a little paragraph for each product on care instructions. That would be a good use case for meta fields. Now, if we have a store that has a sort of a grouping of products that are all the same, let's say we have shirts, right? And all of our shirts, we sort of treat them the same, right? They have different designs, right? But there are the same sort of brand that we're using for those shirts, same vendor, if you will, same for the pants and same for stuff. We have this sort of big groupings of products. In that case, maybe we want to add care instructions. We want to add materials. We want to add dimensions, right? Those three things. Those three things are, they could be individual meta fields, but you can actually group them into a meta object. So it's a lot easier for you to push that content right on the specific product page that you want. So you'll essentially create, let's say we have three categories of products. We have t-shirts, pants, and shoes. We can actually create just one meta object, right? One definition, and then create three groupings of those. And then you're just assigning, right? Anytime that there's a new shirt, you just assign, hey, the t-shirt information goes with this product right here. That way you'll be displayed for the customer on the front end. Now let me show you something a little bit more of a visual. Shopify actually has a really good case study with Smash and Tees. So let's look at how they are using meta objects on their store. So there are three ways that they are using meta objects on their store. Number one is influencer created content. Number two is individual product FAQs and logic-based collection banners. So again, one of the main benefits of having the meta objects is that they don't have to go in to the designer and customize the theme and change a template and deal with all these things. They can just go to their content section and just add new content, and that content automatically gets put on the website. It's sort of the same way that the products work in the back end. You know, you're adding products, you have the product picture, the product description, all the sizing and all that stuff, and that gets automatically added to the store because it's already laid out and, you know, figured out in the actual theme customizer. It's essentially the same way. The first way that Smash and Tees are using it is for, like, right here on the homepage, we have this collab section. Congratulations, Simpson, Jillian Harris, Paula Abdul, and the TV sec. These sections are kind of simple. You know, you have two images, you have the title, you have the link for, I'm guessing their Instagram, shop the collab, and then read the story. So it's a sort of simple section, and they can very quickly change this because they've created meta objects for each individual one of these. So think of this block right here as a meta object with two images, a title, a link, and then another link. So two links, two images, and one title. Like, that's it. That's the grouping of those products. The second thing that they're using Metaobjects for is on their individual product pages. They have these FAQ dropdown, and this dropdown is gonna be a little bit different from product to product or product grouping to product grouping. So they created this grouping of FAQs for individual products. And then lastly, they're using it for their collection pages. So it's not just for the homepage or the product page, they're also using it for the collection page. And they're using it to create these banners right here. So at a glance, you have an image, you have a title, and they have a headline. So that's a very simple grouping, right? These are three fields that are displayed right here. Potentially even four with the background color, that little blush type pink right there in the background. That could also be something that they're using for that whole meta object. Now, before we continue on, I do wanna make sure to remind you about our website VIP day. This is a entirely new process that we created to launch your store in 24 hours, essentially. We'll take care of creating the theme, creating everything for you, product, handling all the backend data for your store, potentially even using Metaobjects and Metafields, right? Check the link in the description below if you're interested in the website VIP day. Now, grab a pen and paper, because we're going to make our own Metaobjects for a store. You already know, totally 90s kid. Now, there are two main key components for Metaobjects, right? Number one is going to be the definition. So the group of fields that defines the object structure. Again, think of this as the definition is like if meta objects were, you know, there are in the back end of Shopify, again, the products, right? Products is the definition. And then the group of fields that would be the headline of the product description, and the product image. Those are all the group of fields that define what a product is, essentially. Now, after we created that, then we have to put it in the entries, right? The actual product, the content, the data for the actual meta object. All right, so we have our handy dandy, totally 90s kid store right here. Now, the two places that you wanna go to for this is settings, custom data, and then in here you'll see meta fields, which we probably used to if you watch some of our videos. And then you scroll down a little bit and you'll see meta objects. Now again, meta objects, we're going to essentially create, for this example, a product highlight section. Now, the other spot that you want to know about, you know, we're in custom data. The second spot is going to be right here under content, and then you'll see meta objects right here. You'll see a list of all your entries and the definitions that they're attached to. Something that I like to do whenever I start to try to think about meta objects and how can I apply them to my store, I actually like to go to my customizer. So I like to go in here and then just kind of see what's available with my theme. And for this example, we're using Dawn. But what I like to do is, like, for example, let's go to an actual product page, because we're going to add a product highlight to our product. And if we go down here, I have this section right here. It's a simple image to the side, I have a headline, and then I have this paragraph right here, and I have a button, which the button I'm not going to use. What I want to do is, within the product page, I want to expand on this particular, on my shirts, right? All my shirts in this store have a technology that makes them super breathable and waterproof. Let's just say that, right? And I want to have an additional section that expands on it. Sure, I may be talking about that in the product description. I may be talking about it within the material section right here, drop down. But again, I want to hit them again with that information and just expand a little bit more on it and even provide some additional imagery. In order to do that, what you want to do is you want to come over here and, like I said, I've added my section, image with text, I think will be the best section within Dawn to sort of achieve this, all this information that I want. And essentially what you want to do is you want to just click around and just see, like, okay, image, is there a dynamic stores that I can connect for my image? I guess if you're not using Dawn, you may be using a different theme and you may not have full capabilities right within all the dynamic sources. So that's why it's important to, I think, look at the sections first and see what's possible to then you can create your meta objects, right? As right here, I can actually connect an image. So I'll be able to add an image to my meta object. It looks like the headline, I can also connect a dynamic source. And then the actual content looks like I can actually connect a dynamic source. And let's just see the button too. Okay, so the button, we can actually do the link and we can do the label. That's completely different things. So if we had maybe a dedicated page, right, for this technology that we're using for clothing, then I could actually tap that button and direct them to that page so they can actually learn more about it. Or maybe they wanna see more products that are using this technology. We can sort of take them to that page. For this example, we're not gonna do the button. So what I'm actually going to do, I'm just gonna go ahead and hide it for now. But again, very simply, we have a meta object here with three different things, right? So we just wanna be thinking about the template and where are you going to be using this information. Let's go and create the actual definition, right? So we're going to go to settings. We're gonna go to custom data, scroll down to meta objects. We're gonna add the definition. Then in here, we're gonna call it just product highlight. And then as far as the fields, we've already determined that we wanna add a single line text. That's gonna be sort of like our heading. So we can do the name of tech. Okay. There's a bunch of options in here where you can actually require the field. You can do minimum, maximum character counts. You can do list of values or just one single value. So you can do a lot of different things in here depending on your needs. So we have the name of it. We're going to add the multi-line text. Actually, let me see if there is a, yeah, let's do rich text and let's do just description of tech. And then the third one that we want to do is we want to add an image. So we're going to do file, do image of tech. Okay, so we created the definition, product highlight. We have the name, the description, and the image of that technology, right, for my product. If you watched our ASRB video, then this is where Aaron and I broke down at ASRB store. I actually talked about this where actually can show you on the product page, they don't expand too much on their fabric and technology. So this is where I kind of got the idea of doing this. They just have like this little paragraph and then that's it. But I would like them to just use the sections and include more information about the tech. They do have a dedicated page. So they actually have the work sort of cut out for them, right? Like they have this section is what I would want to see in the actual product page. And this is essentially what we're going to try to do here is we created our own tech, right, for this fictitious product. And we're going to add this product block highlight into our products. So we added the definition. So we just have the ability, right, to do this. Now we have to go back here to content and meta objects to actually add an individual entry. Like we could have more, and this is the beauty of it is that we can have multiple sets of tech products, right, or technology within our clothing, not tech products. So this first one that we're going to add is for shirts. So we're going to add entry, and then this one's going to be a product highlight. And then I do have this information somewhere. So let me go over here. Okay, so it's called Tempair. Tempair, kind of a weird name, but we'll go with it. And then we have our paragraph here. We're going to paste it. And then I do have those highlights because we selected a rich text. So we can actually do some bullet points for these. So let's do that. Beautiful. And then we're going to select a file. So I'm going to add a new file. We have this image right here. Click done it. And there we go. Okay, so we added the definition. We've added some information, right? We added one entry or one tag for one of our products. And we could definitely add some more. Now we have to make sure that we connect it to the actual product that we want to showcase this with, right? So we created the definition. We've added an entry. Now we have to connect this entry to that product that we wanted to show, and then we'll add it to the template. What we're going to do, this is kind of weird and maybe a little bit confusing, but we have to create a meta field so that we can connect the meta object. So we're gonna go back to settings, we're gonna go back to custom data, and then in here, we'll go to our product. So because we wanna connect this meta object to our products, and then we'll add a definition, and then we'll call it product tech. And then when you select the type, if you scroll down here, you should be able to reference a meta object. And the one that we want to do is the product highlight, and then click save. Now that we connected those two, we just have to make sure that this product right here, the Fresh Prince Design A, is connected to this Tempa Air technology. So we're gonna go to products, we're gonna go find our Fresh Prince, and then here under our meta fields we have our product tech, select entry, and then we should be able to select the Tempa Air. Obviously we have multiple tech, right, for all of our clothing, so we should have a breakdown of all of those entries listed right here. We select the one that we want, we click save, and now we have this product attached to that tech. We go to our template, and then in here, let me refresh this again. Okay, so if we go and look at our section here, we should be able to connect the dynamic source, product tech. You'll see the dropdown. It'll give you the option to select the image. We go back, the text or the headline. We can actually go in here. Again, go to our product tech, the name. Actually, get this text right here. And then our button we want to hide. And then our paragraph here. Let's get rid of this. And then connect our dynamic source, product tech, description of the tech. Click save. And there you have it. Now this product is connected to the tech. Now we have this sort of dynamic section that will not appear if other products are not, you know, connected with any other product tech within our product. You can kind of see the capabilities of Metaobjects. It's going to be very powerful if there are sort of groupings of information that you want to connect to certain products, certain collections, certain pages, etc. So we're sort of just like tip of the iceberg here with Metaobjects and its capabilities. Obviously, this is going to help you tremendously with the selling of the products, making sure that your information is displayed in a way that it's easy for you to manage in the backend. That's one of the most important things with Metaobjects is the organization of your content. And the back end is going to be a lot cleaner, a lot easier. The management of your content in the back end is going to be a lot easier to manage in the future, especially with launching new themes, especially with, you know, even upgrading the version of your theme, right? Doing things like this sort of like the right way, right? And not hard coding things into your store. It's going to be super beneficial because all this information is just stored nicely in the back end. You can update it whenever you want and it will update on all your products. I mean, say this. You decide to change the name of the Tempe Air. You think that that's not a good idea, but you already have hundreds of products connected to that. All you have to do is go to your Metaobjects, update the name of the Tempe Air, boom. All your hundreds of products are updated automatically without you having to lift any additional finger, I guess, from that original one. That's all I have for today. Hopefully this was beneficial. You learned a little bit about what Metaobjects are and how powerful they can be for your store. If you have any questions, please let us know down below. Now, this is not the end of your problems here within your product page. If you want to know exactly what you need to do for your product page and the rest of your product page, you need to watch this video, which will teach you some of the best practices on the product page.